All things must end. It's true for us, it's true for the earth, it's true for the stars, and even our sun. It's not going to happen tomorrow, but one day in far future, the sun will run out of its fuel, ending its life. So before witnessing the end of our star, let's see how a star or our sun evolves over time. Stellar evolution is the process by which a star changes in its lifetime. Depending upon the mass of a star, the lifetime ranges from a few millions of years for the most massive ones to trillions of years for the least massive ones, which is considerably larger than the current age of our universe. All the stars are born from a collapsing cloud of dust and gas, often called as nebula. Over a course of millions of years, these prototype stars settle down into a state of equilibrium and become what's called a main sequence star. In a stable star, just like this balloon, gas pressure pushing outwards from the center, which is equal to the gravity pulling the atoms inward to the center. When these forces are equal, the star is at equilibrium. Nuclear fusion powers the star for most of its life. Energy is generated by fusing hydrogen atoms in the core of a main sequence star. As the preponderance of atoms at the core becomes helium, a star like the sun begins to fuse hydrogen along a spherical shell surrounding the core. The process causes the star to gradually grow in size, passing through the subgiant stage until it reaches the red giant stage. Star with at least half of the mass of the sun can also begin to generate energy through the fusion of helium at its core, whereas more massive stars can fuse heavier elements along a series of concentric shells. From Earth at night, these points of dot look white, but there's a range of colors in which star can exist. The color of a star depends on its surface temperature. Our sun's surface temperature is about 6000 Kelvin. All that looks yellow from here on Earth, the light of the sun is actually very white from space. This white color coming of the sun is due to its temperature, which is 6000 Kelvin. If the sun would be any cooler, it would give off light in the red end of the spectrum. If the sun were hotter, it would appear to be blue. Now let's talk about the death of our star. First, there's no possible way in which our star will explode. It seems huge to us, but the sun is relatively low mass compared to some of the enormous high mass stars in our universe. In about 5 billion years, sun will run out of its hydrogen in the core. When this happens, the inert helium in the core will become unstable and start to collapse under its own weight. This will cause the core to heat up and get denser. The sun will grow in size and enter the red giant phase. The expanding sun will consume the orbit of Mercury, Venus, and probably Earth. Even if the Earth survives, the intense heat from the red sun will scorch our planet and make it completely impossible for life to survive. Once it has become a red giant, sun's death is just around the corner. It still has enough heat and pressure in its core to begin the second phase of fusion, that is burning helium to carbon. This phase will last about 100 million years, until the source of fuel runs out. Finally, the shell of helium becomes unstable, causing the sun to pulse violently. It will blow off a large fraction of its atmosphere into space over a course of several pulses. When the sun has blasted off its outer layers, all that will remain will be a central core of carbon. In fact, it will be an Earth-sized diamond with the mass of a star. So this is a white dwarf. It will still be hot enough to shine with thermal radiation, but it's no longer generating solar fusion. It will slowly cool down until it reaches the temperature similar to the rest of the universe, just a few degrees above absolute zero. In this phase, the star becomes a black dwarf, though this will take about trillions of years to happen. But with this, the death of our sun is complete. Next Thursday, we'll be talking about supernova and black holes. So stay tuned for that, guys. There's a video I made about could Jupiter be a star? If you want to watch it, just click there. If you like the video, please give it a thumbs up, share the video with your friends. And if you have any suggestions, write us in the comments down. And as always, stay curious, stay awesome.